The Ministry of Finance is in charge of national finances. The major role of the MOF is to raise financial resources to support national development. In order to bring soundness to national finances and fulfill our vision of support construction with public finance and raise public finance with construction, the MOF sets a comprehensive structure for its six main tasks of public finance management, tax administration, customs administration, public asset management, the promotion of private participation in infrastructure projects, and the handling of international fiscal affairs. Fiscal soundness is the foundation of national economic development. Public finance management, improving financial management and effectiveness. Public finance management includes the management of fiscal revenue and expenditure, government debt, local finance, tobacco and alcohol administration, and supervision of the public welfare lottery. The MOF acts in compliance with the Budget Act, which states that current revenues and expenditures of the government shall be balanced. If there is a surplus, it may be used for capital expenditures. And in recent years, there has been a current surplus. Insufficient amounts of capital expenditure may be funded by public debt under the condition that the balance may not exceed 40% of the average GNP of the previous 3 years pursuant to the Public Debt Act. And our amount of debt is adequate in comparison with international levels. The purpose of expanding public expenditure is to build and renew infrastructure so as to benefit current and future generations. And the projects will be funded by public debt, thus allowing the burden between the different generations to be more equal. In order to bring soundness to local finances, the MOF uses the allocation of centrally funded tax revenues and subsidies to moderate local finance, support local development, and encourage local fiscal efforts. The MOF also conducts a program for assisting local government finance to develop local financial resources and enhance local fiscal autonomy. In addition, the MOF also works to strengthen the administration of tobacco and alcohol products and supervises the public welfare lottery to promote social welfare. In line with the Golden Decade Plan announced by the President, a program to ensure sustainable development has been put into place, and the MOF will continue in the promotion of tax and fiscal reforms based on related fiscal strategies. Ensuring sound finance supports economic development. Tax administration, to build a high quality and more convenient and effective tax environment. Currently, there are 18 taxes in Taiwan. Revenue from taxes comprises about 72% of net government revenues of all levels. Revenue from income tax is about 42% of the total tax revenues, comprising the largest share, and revenue from business tax is about 16%. Total revenue from direct taxes is about 60% of total tax revenues. The average annual tax burden in Taiwan has been 12.8% in the past 5 years, lower than that of other major countries. Tax revenues are from the people and for the people, and the government nurtures a favorable investment environment and creates more jobs and a better quality of living through effective national budgeting. In order to build a high-quality tax environment, enhance competitiveness, and develop a sustainable economy, the MOF emphasizes enhancing tax efficiency, broadening tax base, and streamlining tax administration. We promote tax reform and streamline tax-related laws and rules. The National Tax Bureaus examine significant tax evasion cases and pursues payment of tax revenues from major tax evaders to protect social justice. Each year, the tax authorities handle about 26 million tax cases, of which about 10,000 are subject to recheck. The ratio of application for recheck is 0.04%, which shows that the quality of tax auditing is high. In line with the rapid development of information technology and public voices for more choice and diversity, The MOF, in the spirit of service, has established general service counters to provide more diverse services to the public and offers an e-invoice platform and multiple ways by which tax payments may be made. In order to provide further excellent service, the MOF continues to streamline tax administration. For example, we provide more than 460 online services, including forms for download, online search, and application. We also promote the filing of tax returns online. Almost 100% of business tax returns and profit-seeking enterprise income tax returns and about 76% of individual income tax returns are filed online. The more people who file online, the fewer who have to wait in line, which saves time and money and makes life easier and more convenient. Moreover, in order to continue to provide an excellent service, we are promoting two measures: proactiveness in providing the individual taxpayer with his or her information on deductions for individual consolidated income tax, and the pre-calculation service for individual consolidated income tax, whereby if taxpayers confirm the calculation or pay tax as stated on the tax bills, they are deemed to have completed their income tax return filing. These measures have saved much time and resources in filing and serve to reduce compliance costs. The MOF will work continuously to promote the re-engineering of tax information to reach the goals of being more convenient, more innovative, and more effective. Customs Administration, strengthening of customs management and facilitating customs clearance. Revenue from customs duties is around 90 billion NT dollars annually. The customs also collects 300 billion NT dollars in taxes and charges on behalf of authorized agencies and provides customs clearance services for 35 million travelers and 8.5 million containers a year. In order to assist the traders in reducing logistics costs and increasing logistical efficiency through providing safer and more convenient customs clearance services, the customs applies modern technology and risk management to simplify and standardize customs administration. Customs is working in cooperation with the licensing and harbor agencies to build a customs maritime trade single window system and is implementing an AEO system. It also utilizes an RFID system and X-ray inspection machines, and it uses detector dogs to assist in the interception of drug smuggling. It takes only about 30 minutes on average for imports to go through clearance procedures and about 10 minutes for exports. The tax refund shopping system enables foreign travelers leaving Taiwan to obtain a VAT refund on goods which they buy here and then take home. Asset management. Activate utilization of national property to realize the value of assets. The MOF manages about 8.9 trillion NT dollars in public assets, most of which are in the form of land. The MOF uses development strategies, such as the promotion of public-private partnerships, to encourage the private sector to invest and so create a better quality of life for the people. And the use of these strategies also allows the government to reduce the construction costs of infrastructure and to collect more royalties and rents and thus increase revenue. Through innovations in the ways in which premises and land are used, cross-sector cooperation and land development programs, we increase the self-liquidation ratio, encourage private sector participation, and make use of private funds, creativity and efficiency, so as to accelerate the construction of public infrastructure. In order to promote the sustainable operation of national assets and the sharing of the benefits with the people, the management of public assets is integrated across regions and is utilized to create additional value, enhance overall benefits in the construction of infrastructure, and establish a new regime for fiscal management. Promotion of private participation in infrastructure projects to combine with private capital and enhance the effectiveness of infrastructure services. With the promulgation of the Act for Promotion of Private Participation in Infrastructure Projects in 2000, the government expanded the scope of infrastructure projects for private participation from transportation facilities, power supply facilities, and refuse incineration plants to 20 items in 13 categories. The PPIP Act is a special law made by the government to facilitate private participation in infrastructure projects. The spirit of the law is founded in the desire to improve the quality of public services and establish partnerships between the government and private enterprises. The government hopes to stimulate Taiwan's economy and help enhance the effectiveness of infrastructure services through the engagement of the private sector, thereby creating a win-win-win scenario, one beneficial to government, enterprises, and the general public. International fiscal affairs, signing of international agreements, and promotion of international fiscal cooperation and exchanges. In order to avoid double taxation, reduce the uncertainty of the tax burden and investment risk, ensure the interests of the people and companies, enhance the international competitiveness of Taiwan businesses, and enhance Taiwan's investment environment, the MOF is actively engaged in the conclusion of tax agreements with foreign countries. We work to create a sustainable, low-tax environment to increase the willingness to invest. With the growth in international trade, customs cooperation agreements and memorandum of understanding on information sharing are signed to advance trade security and facilitation and enhance multilateral relationships in the field of trade and economy. In addition, we are active in the signing of the fiscal cooperation MOUs with other countries and in promoting international cooperation and exchanges. And we are also active in mastering world trends through interaction with relevant international organizations within the international fiscal system. The MOF also provides various international personnel and language training programs, and cooperates with well-known universities and organizations to hold international workshops and conferences as part of the training programs for financial officers and to create a platform for the exchange of experiences between international tax scholars, experts, and officials as well. About 1,300 trainees participate in the training programs related to international affairs each year. Vision: support construction with public finance and raise public finance with construction. The vision of the MOF is support construction with public finance, raise public finance with construction. Sound finance is the foundation of economic development. We persist in functional finance and work to sustain a balanced economy supported by sound finance to create a vigorous and sustainable economy.